First chapter, third section, shloka number 1 to 9. So yesterday in the last session we saw there's a karma kanda section, there's a upasana kanda, and there's jnana kanda. Okay, so traditionally in the ancient times people go through these three: karma kanda, upasana kanda, and jnana kanda. So modern today's time also, in some way we go through. We do the prayers, bhajans, then we do karma yoga, and then you start going to jnana yoga. Is all this necessary for a mature soul? For a mature soul, Sri Ramana Maharshi suggested direct path of self-inquiry. Find out who I am. Okay, so that requires certain maturity of the mind. Mind has to be already calm. Mind has to become peaceful through earlier lifetime or this lifetime. You have done sadhana to bring the mind to a state of calmness. For a mature seeker, there is a direct path. Okay, direct path is to find out who am I. So this is based on there is a teaching for self-knowledge. Yamadharmaraya starts giving the teaching of self-knowledge to Nachiketa. He says there are two selves in the body. There are two selves in the body. One of the Atma or the Self is samsari. Samsari means he is involved in the world. He is involved, he goes through joy and suffering. Okay, he goes through cycle of birth and death. He is called samsari. One of them. The other one is free. He is not in samsara. He is beyond. Those who are wise jnanis, they realize this, the one who is asamsari, one who is not involved in samsara, who is atma, they become free. There are others who follow the path of karma kanda. They follow panchagni vidya, nachiketa agni vidya. So these practices they do to realize the asamsari, the self, atman. Right? There is a samsari and asamsari. Samsari means one who is involved in samsara, who is going through the suffering, who is going through joy and sorrow. And he says there are two atmas. Okay? There are two atmas in the body. Now this concept of two atma, we have to be very careful about this. The self, two self. Okay? In Sanskrit, when we use the words can mean multiple things, meanings. At one sense, body is atma. Okay, another sense, ego is atma. In the ultimate sense, the self is atma. Okay, the same word is used in the context. We have to understand the context. For example, you go and buy a coconut from a tree. Coconut which has fallen from the tree. So what you call it as coconut? It's a husk. Husk is there. So remove the husk, the coconut shell is there. That also you call it as coconut. They break that shell and internal kernel is there. That also is coconut. Which is coconut really?
Inside that.
Whatever is the kernel is the coconut. But for the coconut, which is fresh from the tree with husk, that also you call as coconut. Okay. So the coconut with the shell is also a coconut. Finally, the kernel is a coconut. Really, the kernel is coconut. But you call all the three as coconut. Like that. When I point to you, your body is Atma. Okay. This is Atma because it's like an outer shell or husk. Okay. So the mind is also Atma. The intellect is also Atma. Finally, the real Atma is the innermost self. Okay. So when the Upanishad says there are two Atma, you should not get confused. Atma is only one. Okay. For the purpose of clarification, I have told the way they use the words. There are no two Atma, there is only one Atma. Atma means essence. Okay. One is real and other is apparent. Real and apparent Atma. The real Atma is Paramatma, real Atma is Brahman. Then there is apparent Atma. Okay. So, what we think we are, we live as apparent Atma. Mean the appearance of Atma, we think we are. We think we are the body, we are the mind, we are the intellect, and we live with that understanding. And that one who lives like that, that is called samsari Atma. He is in samsara, the world. It also, I can say, one who has identified is a body, mind and intellect, I call it as ego self, ego. There's an ego involved. So that ego self is called samsari because it goes through turbulence of life. One who is not associated, one who is witnessing this whole body-mind complex, he is asamsari, is not involved in samsara. So the apparent self or the ego self or the jiva, all of them in the same thing. Through performance of yajna, through meditation, through jnana, he will realize the real self rather than the apparent self. Okay? One who realizes the real self becomes free from suffering in life. He becomes a Jivan Mukta or liberated while he is alive. Is this clear?